Okay, here we go. This is just some recent mail that came in, and then three packages. I'm trying to focus more on players I want to collect for the PSA set registry, and focus on Hall of Famers. Try to get away from the young players, the rookies, the guys that haven't proven it. So most of the time, or a lot of the time, they usually flake out, but this is just an SP photo variation, 15 tops chrome of Falk. That was a neat card for $5, and then here's basketball. I just started collecting basketball. This is like the throwback retro 86-87 Fleer look. The set that has the Jordan rookie, and that's a Durant. And then Donruss Classics Breeze. Very condition sensitive. These gold borders just tend to always be chipped. So it's something, if you could find a PSA 9 of this, you should hold on to it. I think that's like an 8 or 7. I didn't add this, and I wanted to put it into my master set. I don't know if that's the design of the card. If it's the card, looks like somebody put a piece of tape on there and just pulled it up. But this is UD Honor Roll, I think. No, it's UD Rookie FX to 750. Vanguard. I was never a huge fan of Vanguard. But this one's got a pretty low print run, and I wanted to put it into the PSA set registry. It's fun building up the master sets and adding new cards and seeing kind of how your rank goes up and down. Very cool. Pros and Prospects. This card is incredibly undervalued in my opinion. It's got the same print run as the Tom Brady from the year before. The Brady Raw goes for about, what, 150 to 200, and the Breeze, you can get these for like $15, so. It's a steal, and it's not the toughest set to grade, so. It's a bargain. And a couple autos, they're both on card. Bowman's Best, this is just the insert auto. There's no print run on these, but if I had to guess, I'd say they're probably 500 to 600 range. Chipping on the bottom left. And this set's seems pretty easy to me just because it's white. SP Authentic white cards that are thin usually do pretty well. Not much that can alter the grade too much. So that's a sign of the autos on card. Now three packages. Brought back this old boy out of retirement. Interesting. It's the same fabric as like when you buy a bottle of Crown. I put the Crown in there like this. These are kind of cool. Kind of a waste. Peyton Manning, Upper Deck. This is one of the most iconic cards I've ever seen. PSA 10s for about 100, 125. 9s for about, it's like 25. So, I mean, that's a steal. This one looks fantastic. This is the first thing I always look at when I'm looking at this set, 98 Upper Deck. If I'm grading a Moss or a Manning, this back border. Then the second thing is this. So those are the two things that chip the most often. Obviously that one. This one looks great. That might be just a centering issue on this. And then this was something that sold for a little bit of a discount because of the grader. So I've got a couple options. This is more iconic than the card before it, but this is the Future Watch 98. So it's graded by GAI, who was big in the early to mid 2000s, and I think they kind of went out of business, or I haven't heard anything about them lately. But GAI, they actually grade pretty tough, so my thought process was this, was buy at a discount and either do a crossover with PSA, or just snap it and send it to PSA and just gamble a little bit. From what I'm seeing right here, it looks fantastic. I mean, the only thing I might see is that top right corner that could hold it back, but GAI Mint 9, and it's the factory stamped one, so sweet card right there. And then I threw in these velvet things, so can't go wrong with the velvets. I think this is the cutter I used when I made some of my first videos. Go around. The basketball card. That's UD Victory. LeBron James, that's in. I'm starting up the master set for him too. Master and the rookie. This one probably won't do. I don't think it's a 10. I think it's an 8 or a 9. Just that corner right there. I mean, when you buy a card, I mean, I'm just a huge grader, so I just kind of take a quick glance over it. Looks a little off-center. It's a little white, so probably not a 10. But still a neat card. Simple card. $8, $10. Here's the last one. Could be something nicer. If it's in a small flat rate box. Yeah, this filth moss. PSA 9. So, some of these were hand numbered because I think they were factory damaged. Some people don't know that. So if you see one online where the serial numbering is like written in gold pen, that's because they were damaged and Upper Deck sent replacements out. Those are actually valued less. I think people pay about 20% less on those ones. So this is one that's factory stamped. I prefer the factory stamped. I don't know why. It just seems like it was from the first batch that wasn't flawed. So, but this is an awesome card. I think it'll only continue to go up in value. These have gone up in the last 5 years or so. There's only 2,000 of them out there. There's probably a lot of Moss fans that are going to be collected in the future. So. That's it for today. We'll have more stuff in next week. I got a huge order I bought from a seller on eBay. You guys have probably heard of him. His name is Four Sharp Corners, and some of his prices are a little high, but he's got a lot of great deals on lower end PSA stuff. So I picked up some Griffey and Frank Thomas stuff. So we'll do a video on that when it comes in. And that's it for now. Later.